Some of you may have thought of this already, and that is, prior to P2 getting its lock, it is possible that maybe another processor, say P3, also used the same lock. And so when it executed its critical section, maybe in its critical section, it modified the page X again, and it created its own diff, let's call it XD prime. Because all of these locks are the same, when the DSM software knows that now there are two diffs associated with this lock L. One diff is with the processor P1, and another diff is residing with processor P3, and therefore, when processor P2 tries to access X, the DSM software has not only to get the diff from P1, but it also needs to get the diff from P2 and apply it to the original pristine version of the page that is with the owner of the page so that it can create the current version of the page. And you can extend this to any number of processors that may have made modifications, their own modifications, to this page under the provision of this lock L. All of those diffs are going to be applied in order for the processor P2 to access the page as the current page. If after accessing the page X in its execution, P2 touches, let's say, page Z, at that point, once again, the DSM software knows that, oh, I know that Z was modified by the previous lock holder, ZD is the diff, I know where to find it, I'll bring the original copy of Z from the owner of Z and apply the diffs to it before letting P2 access Z. So you can see that even though the invalidation was done right at the beginning, we are procrastinating getting the diffs till the point of access. So this is what LRC allows you to do, is just bring in what this guy needs. So for instance, inside this critical section, maybe only X is accessed. Y and Z are not accessed at all, in which case we never bring the diffs from P1 to P2 for Y and Z. On the other hand, it is possible that P2, as part of its execution of its critical section, modifies another page Q, different from X, Y, and Z. So now the DSM software knows that this particular lock is associated not just with X, Y, and Z, but it is also associated with Q. So future lock requests for L will result in invalidating X, Y, Z, and Q because all of those may have been modified, and the next critical section that wants to access this lock L has to get the current versions of all the pages that were ever associated with L.